The police raid Fontana Leisure Park inside the Clark Freeport Zone Tuesday, May 19, after the discovery of an illegal makeshift hospital for Chinese citizens suspected of infection with the coronavirus. Clark Development Corporation says Wednesday morning it ordered the closure and full lockdown of the resort. The CDC says the hospital is not only illegal, but also poses a danger to individuals who potentially need medical treatment for COVID-19. The Philippine National Police Criminal Investigation and Detection Group Region 3 and the Food and Drug Administration conducted the joint raid. Authorities arrested two Chinese, Wu Ling, the alleged owner of the underground hospital, and alleged pharmacist Lee Sung-hyun. This is not the first time Fontana was involved in a controversy. In December 2016, the resort's casino was shut down following the arrest of some 1,200 illegal Chinese workers inside the premises. Meantime, as of Wednesday, May 20, there are now 13,221 COVID-19 cases in the country. The health department raises the death toll to 842 and the recoveries to 2,932. Presidential Advisor for Entrepreneurship Joey Concepcion slams doctors who say rapid test kits on returning workers would be a waste of resources.
Kasi yung problema ng itong mga doktor, salita ng salita, wala naman ginagawa, complain ng complain. Ang mangyayari dito, kung magsisarado uli yung ekonomiya ng Pilipinas, maraming mawawala ng trabaho.
Medical groups earlier said it's still better to use the real-time reverse transcription polymerase chain reaction, or RT-PCR tests, for returning workers. Rapid test kits have a faster turnaround time of 45 minutes, but can only detect antibodies and should still be validated with RT-PCR tests. Results from RT-PCR test kits are supposed to be released in 24 hours, but there's a backlog in processing the results. Concepcion insists rapid tests are all that the government can do for now.
So my appeal to all of these doctors, if you have a better alternative, why don't you tell us a better alternative? You want us to get the capacity of the PCR test? Well, there's none. What can we do?
A few hours after, Concepcion clarifies his earlier remarks were not meant to criticize doctors and apologizes if it came off that way. He says there is a need to save both lives and the Philippine economy, and increasing the country's testing capacity would help achieve this. Meantime, Health Undersecretary Maria Rosario Vergere says it is not cost-effective to prioritize the testing of those who do not exhibit coronavirus symptoms. She says the country's healthcare system does not have the capacity for it right now. There are at least 30 accredited facilities nationwide able to test COVID-19 samples, but the country conducts only 11,500 tests per day. Vergere also clarifies the use of the term expanded testing instead of mass testing, as the limited capacity is forcing the country to prioritize certain sectors. But Marikina Representative Stella Kimbo slams the reasoning. She says if there is an activity like mass testing, which is not costly but the benefits are huge, then you find the budget for that. President Rodrigo Duterte defends Metro Manila Police Chief Debold Sinas in a speech aired late night Tuesday, May 19. He calls Sinas a good officer and an honest one.
Hindi niya kasalanan kung may magharana sa kanya sa birthday niya. At kung yun ang sabi na nakikita hindi naka-mask, eh siyempre may mga merienda yan, may pagkain. Alang-alang naman kainin nila pati yung mask.
Duterte says he is sure Sinas would have disagreed had he known his men were planning a surprise party for him. The president says, quote, "I will not order his transfer. He stays there until further orders." Sinas and 18 other policemen face criminal cases for violating physical distancing during the coronavirus lockdown. Last May 8, policemen surprised Sinas with a mañanita or early morning serenade for his 55th birthday. Meantime, in the same speech, a song Duterte said captures, quote, "the spirit that we have been longing for and what we feel for the moment" was played back. Duterte, with head in his hand, looked very solemn and troubled.
Kailangan mo magpalakas para sila'y mailigtas. Buwis ang iyong buhay, handang matanggap pag ika'y mamatay. Asawa't anak na hindi masilayan.
This is not the first time Duterte had a song played during an event broadcast to the public. Back in 2016, when he just won the presidency, he had a song composed for him by folk musician Freddy Aguilar played during a press conference. Senator Cynthia Villar apologizes Wednesday, May 20, for a remark on the middle class that earned the ire of Filipinos online. Villar said the government shouldn't extend cash assistance to middle-class families affected by the coronavirus lockdown. She says, quote, "I might have framed my questions and statements in such a manner that made it seem I was insensitive to the plight of the middle-income sector. I am not." This comes after Villar, in a Senate inquiry on Tuesday, cites the 2015 census where only 59% of Filipino families were considered poor. She then assumed the 18 million family beneficiaries of the government's emergency subsidy program included those from the middle class.
Bakit bibigyan yung middle? Eh, may trabaho sila, kahit lockdown, nagsusweldo sila sa gobyerno, kung employed by the government, kung employed naman ang local, eh, ng mga private, nagsusweldo din sila. Kaya nga nahihirapan yung mga companies kasi they have to pay the salaries even if there's no business.
This did not sit well with Filipinos online. Twitter user @HuntressOfSteel seems to encapsulate the online user's sentiments. Bold of you to assume everyone's salaries are enough to sustain a family in this pandemic. User @JMoniel asks if Villar was informed that factories, firms, and businesses are closed during the lockdown. Antoinette Villanueva Rodriguez says the senator should practice empathy. This is not the first time the richest senator earned the ire of Filipinos online. In 2019, online users slammed Villar for her comments on the prices of galunggong or round scad. Speaker Alan Peter Cayetano says the House of Representatives should be ready to decide on the grant of a fresh 25-year franchise to media giant ABS-CBN by August. This means the network will have to stay off air for another 3 months. Cayetano's statement comes after the House dropped a bill seeking to grant the media giant a provisional franchise valid until October 31, 2020. House Committee on Legislative Franchises Chair Franz Alvarez says Wednesday, May 20, the next hearing for the ABS-CBN franchise bill is scheduled on Tuesday, May 26. ABS-CBN President and CEO Carlo Catigbac told senators Tuesday, May 19, the media giant may begin retrenching some of its workers by August if it is not allowed to operate by then.